Good morning. Welcome to DDOwiki Talk with T13, with your host here, ShoeMaker. Or Technical 13, or whatever you want to call me, as long as it's not late for dinner. A couple minutes late starting the stream because I wanted to get some background music. Something that was legit. I figured the best music for this type of show that I think is a really good music is we switch over here. It's actually the Hall of Heroes music. Let me know if it's loud or quiet and I will adjust it accordingly. This week on DDOwiki Talk, we will be working on... I'm not getting any chat here. Alright, so the music is a little bit loud. We've got it like literally at 10% here. There, how's that? I cut it in half. If I have to, I'll go in game and turn it down some more. I don't know yet. I have to get a landlord permission slip, and my landlord's been on vacation, so hopefully soon. So on DDOwiki Talk today, we are going to be doing our 10th anniversary show. Alright, so for the 10th anniversary show, let's see here. Let's start with a grand prize poll. So, the person with the most votes will get a section about them added to the homepage of the wiki. That was me. So, I need to write something about myself because I didn't get a lot of good stories. I got a couple little stories, and those will definitely be included. So, if you have stories about how I influenced your gameplay as a DDOwiki contributor, please let me know in chat here. It is very... And for the still active in-game section, it is very likely going to be lifetime free VIP. So, let's... Good morning, enemy food. Oh, I should probably mention, I will not be doing my normal weekly giveaway this week. Instead, what I'm going to be doing is I am going to be going through the new contributors. Anybody that watches the stream, has created a wiki account and made at least one edit, if you comment me your name in chat, you will be entered to win one of five starter packs. So I added a section to the prize list for new contributors to the wiki because of the DDO stream, and they will all get a starter pack or a 500 turbine point code if that's what they prefer. So let me know who you are on wiki in chat here, and you will be entered to win one of five starter packs. This is going to be a link to the show. Well, then you can take the option of the 500 turbine points if you'd rather have that instead of the starter pack. The starter pack isn't exactly an adventure pack. It does include the Catacombs adventure pack, but also includes a permanent hireling level 3, a scorpion companion 250 turbine points, and some XP elixirs. So we'll be getting into that shortly. I want to give everybody, you know, 20 more minutes or so to get in here and start watching before I really get into the details. Unconfirmed at this time. Alright, so take a look at that. Now that we've reworded it, template unconfirmed. Maybe it's unverified. Good morning, Edward. There we go, that'll work. And our winner was... I don't like the really bright green. I really don't. So let's go with AA RGB FFAA. See what that looks like. Doesn't apply it to both sections, but that's okay. There we go. Alrighty, so we're gonna save that. Good morning, LB Doubleot. So yeah, at the bottom here, I added another tier for, I need a cough drop or something. Dying here. Grab me a handful out of the sack. I got a sack of cough drops over there, so. Alrighty. So, yeah, I added a new prize for 5 DDO Stream New Editor Awards, which means that if you're a new editor on the wiki and you're watching this stream and this is why you decided to edit and you're in the stream today, then you need to comment your DDOwiki username. And you will be eligible. I will pick 5 out of however many there are to win either a DDO starter pack or 500 turbine point code. The defender of the wiki prize, I think, is going to get dumped because I was unable to complete the script that gave me the information I needed for that. I actually don't have very good information on that. Pages patrolled and minor edits, those are all going to get dumped for now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to retroactively award them later. It may take me a couple more weeks to finish the script to be able to find the winners for those. Row span equals 2. Yes, you may, Titan. And you don't need to beg. It's not very becoming. Good morning, Xander. Please, you. Please let me enter. Security. Oopsie. That didn't look right. I should have done a show preview. Let's see if we can fix that. Ah, right. I know what's up. There we go, we're getting closer here. Just gotta fix the last one down here. No, I was right. Should be row. But I need to add those in there. There. That should look right. There we go. Well, I see we're up to 9 viewers so far. Make sure that you comment your DDOwiki username in chat so that I know that you're here and I know who to award the prizes to. It's useful if you have on wiki email set up so that I can just email you the link, although I can send it through Twitch as well. This whole section is going to be this. I never did figure out what good prizes for those would be. I'll have to get back around to that. Wiki Washer and Wiki Watcher. I don't have any soundtracks yet, Titan. And I like it. It sounds very wiki-ish. I don't have any soundtracks. I am actually just in the Hall of Heroes. There you go. So, what's the difference between Wiki Washer and Wiki Watcher? Wiki Washer is for the most minor edits, people that go in and fix typos and punctuation and grammar and spelling and those kinds of things, and mark their edits as minor. If you mark your edits as minor and they're not, you will get yelled at for that. It's just annoying. It's like, doesn't break anything. Not a big deal, but it's annoying. So you might get, you know, a little notice on your talk page saying, hey, make sure you only mark minor edits as minor. And then pages patrolled is Wiki Watcher. Means that every time that somebody that doesn't have DDOwiki VIP or higher, every time they make an edit, a little red exclamation mark shows up next to their edit. And it's up to the page patrollers to look at those edits and make sure that there's nothing malicious in there. There usually isn't. Occasionally there are typos and things that need to get fixed, or there are things that belong on a talk page instead of an actual page, and you might shuffle some stuff around. So being a page patroller might result in you having to make a minor edit to fix something, but minor edits are the ones that are either typographical in nature or have no effect on the display of the page, the content of the page. That's the difference between washer and watcher. It's the difference between patrolling other people's edits and going through and fixing typos and non-essential things. So, I don't have all of the data for edit count prizes either. However, I do have enough data for the top couple tiers, the 25,000 plus and the 10,000 plus, so I can put those in there. Starter pack. This is what's in the starter pack for those people that are interested. Catacombs Adventure Pack, Fiendish Scorpion Pet, Permanent Cleric Hireling, 5 Excellent Experience Elixirs, and 250 Turbine Points. So, special pages. Let's just do special count edits. So if we go to this page, it'll give us our list of people for 10,000 and above. We're not sure about 5,000 and above. There could be a couple more down there, but we got to start here. So ShoeMaker has this many contributions. $400 contributions since I did this earlier. Alrighty. In the 10,000 column, can delete that. What do we have? We have Cobalt Sneak. He's a bot. We have Yoko 5,000. He has 17,096. Hey, he broke 17K. Niblung. What else do we have here? Niblung and Blade Edge. The bot doesn't count. Cobalt Sneak is actually a community bot account that anybody can use, really. Alright, so that's those. And we can fill in Alright, so now we go down here, we get Shade, who hasn't changed. JJ has changed. Guild remember hasn't changed. So Shade 95, 21, 81, 36. Oops, Shade actually lost one. And Guild remember 81, 36, that's good. One of his must have gotten deleted. JJ is that. Crew 121 is that. Eldrion is that, unchanged. And Emjol is 6533, which should be unchanged. All right, so. I'm gonna get to that in a little bit, Titan. So, for our 25,000 plus, who win a mystery prize from Zevo, it's an Amazon gift card. I'm not gonna disclose how much it is, but it is a gift card. And 2,500 turbine points. That'll probably come as 500 turbine point codes from Cordovan. To me, yes! Woohoo! I will probably save those codes and give them away in future streams. Possibly giving those particular codes away on the Shoe Cobbles A insert build here. Our 10,000 plus edits, edit awards go to Yoko5000, Niblung, and Blade Edge, who also get a mystery prize from Zevo. And 1500 turbine points is what the current plan is. Cordovan might just say that those are too much and decide to truncate it some or chop it off or something. That'll be up to him. He's probably still sleeping at 8:30 in the morning, however, so getting feedback from him on that is unlikely at this time. For 5,000 plus, well, let's see if we can add some more numbers, users to that. Let's visit my page, for example. Anyways, 5,000 plus will get two 500 turnby point codes and their choice of a pet certificate, either Merry Mimic, Owlbear, or Wolfpup. So far we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people there. 2,500 plus, I don't have any people listed yet, but I will have some by the end of the day. They get 500 turbine points and their choice of a pet certificate. And then 1,000 plus gets their choice of any 3 community loot list items, and 500 gets a community loot list item. So let's see if we can add some more names to this list. We go to the bottom here and we go to users. We actually have this table here that has some names in it. There's nothing in 25,000 because it's not the way that it's designed. 10,000 has those four, which is good. 5,000. Okay, so what do we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And over here, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm missing one from the 5,000 plus, and I think is Lord Silverhand. It is. So if I go to count edits and I throw his name in there, it's going to give me a mess of HTML code, but it tells me that he has 5216, which does put him in the 5,000 category. So if I go there's that one. Now if I look here, I'm going to take a look at the ones that are in 2500. Ultra Monk. $34.73. So he goes down here. Alrighty, if you're getting an error, you need to send me a notice, send me a PM, or get in touch with me some way and give me your email address, and I will I will create the account for you, and you will get a temporary random password generated by the wiki. I just need your email address to do that. So, 3473. 3473. Who's next in the list? Teocan. Some of these users are no longer active, and I don't have any way to get in touch with them. If you know them, and and you know how to get in touch with them, let them know that they won a prize, and if they're interested, they need to send me an email. And I will be happy to make sure they get their prizes. Susalona, who's been editing a bit lately. Oh, who was that I just did? Susalona has 4268. Can. Next one is Robin. How close is Massachusetts to Washington? I have no idea. The other side of the country? Unless you mean Washington, D.C. And then I would say it's 500 to 800 miles. 3104. I actually know how to get in touch with Elliot Cable. 3304 for Neo. I will sort these once I get all the accounts in there. Elliot Cable has 4334. This person's been really moving up here. We'll see what they're at. 2565. Ooh! Just cutting it. They've probably just this week got enough edits to get into the 2500 category. That's awesome, in my opinion. Let's see what the old Borror has. 3702. Love to see people like that if they would actually like come back to editing the wiki. Come back to DDO, we miss you. Backley has 3,300 even. Now moving on to the 1,000 edit list. And Yogg has 1,224. Curlon, who I've actually seen come back lately, has 2034. Snake. These all go down in the next section here. TB will go to the bottom. Just love that music. So I need at least 9 there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Throw in a good one for good measure. Sforza. Seffi, who was a major influence to me when I first started. I actually have him on my Facebook. Borge has 2188. Joe Nuts. Has 1830. Any update on DarkWiki theme? That would be a user skin, and I've had zero time whatsoever to work on that. You want to know what my recommendation is on that? Go to Freenode on IRC, look it up on Wikipedia. Go Wikipedia, IRC, and find Freenode. And then go to channel #DDOwiki. And look for Elliot Cable, EC. And ask him about it. He would be an awesome guy to make a skin. He made the Wiki's original True Glass skin. So we got Dedrid has 1855. CDR 1811. Agu, who is getting back from a tour overseas and should be active again shortly, although not so much as of yet. He's actually supposed to be watching the stream today. Who is administrating the user category, or do we have to do it ourselves? You do it yourselves, but there's nothing to really do except, well, for now, except for 1740. You know that user edit award template that you put on your page? That actually automatically takes care of adding you to your user categories. So as long as you keep that updated every tier, you will be in the right group in your category. Now, let's see here. That's 1,000 edit users. Let's check the 500 edit user list. Spencer has 1100, so he fits in here. And that's why I had an extra one there. I might need a few extra ones. 827, so that doesn't fall into 1000. Silverside. old. No silver side old. So silver side. I'll have to research that one. That one's buggy. Firo 420 had 694. Says 500, hasn't been updated apparently. Put in your exact edit count. It's always a good thing. It's 510. Dragon Star. $685. Absolutely. I can do that. I got your whisper. A Horsley Jr. $726. DDO stream, I guess we can skip that one. Because that's kind of a community account. Although I'm the only one that has access to it at the moment. I could, you know, merge it into my account and delete it. 817 for CT Larson. And then we'll do Core Breach. $655. All right, so let's put these in numerical order here. 510. Go to the bottom. 655. 817. So that's in order. Alright, so we got 1100. $1,200. $1,303. $1,338. 2188. 15 goes below 17. Let's go below that. Goes down there. That goes there. Okay. And up here, we've got a 4,000. A 4,000. 2,000, 31, just a hair more. They're all really close right there. That's a neck and neck battle right there if you ask me. All right, and up here, those are already in order. So good to go. Round out the winners up to 500 plus edits. I still have to I still have to go through the 250. Sip of coffee here. All right, so let's pull up your email. Special sign up. Login. Sign up. You can't see what I'm doing in the other one over here, so email address, put that in there. All right, Fire of the Red Dragon, have you put in your wiki username in the chat yet? Could you do it again just to make sure? And I'll make sure that if you're the winner, you get your prize. Okay, good. Alright, so so check your email. You should have it shortly. Alrighty, so let's see here. Blade Edge doesn't have an email, but I think I can get a hold of him another way. Looks like everybody else. Oh, Boro doesn't have an email. Neo doesn't have an email, but I know how to get a hold of Neo and Kenneth. I can get a hold of Boro through the forums usually. Wow, Spencer doesn't have a talk page. Interesting. I don't know how to get a hold of Eepy. I don't know how to get a hold of Dragonstar, Core Breach, or MC Glonic. So, if you know how to get a hold of those people, let me know. Alrighty, so I do believe it is time. We're not going to worry about working on that right now. That's the community loot list. So those people that fall into the 1,000 plus or the 500 plus can... pick any item on the community loot list page that isn't a companion. I need to update that to specify that. I got an email. Amazon Prime and Newegg.com. So you've logged in. when you've got less than 100 edits? I don't understand that comment, Edward. You're a user as soon as you create an account and verify it. I've created the account, he just needs to verify it. Oh, right. Alright, so that's that. So, for that script I was talking about, let's do this so you can actually see it. We don't care about line numbers. There we go. So, this is JavaScript. It's a huge JavaScript. I set up some variables. I make a log event function to be able to turn on and off logging to clean up my console a little bit. If is logging is true, then console log anything that's log event that's passed into it. Otherwise, logging is turned off. You can see that being used down here, log event obtaining list of namespaces. So what it does is it sends obtaining list of namespaces to log event, and then it passes it through as event log. If logging is true, then it logs whatever this is to the console log. Otherwise, it just skips it and moves on. I got a text message. Awesome. Okay. That's just a logging thing. I'll need to modify it and prove it later. I have a little function to convert a word to up to capitalize the first letter, so I can do camel case stuff if I want to, by passing in a string, and then it'll uppercase the first one, and I can just stack them together and make camel case or whatever. Minor formatting thing. I have a function that gets a list of namespaces from the API. So it does a query for site info namespaces. It doesn't actually need this format JSON, that's the default. Once it gets that, then it takes the site info response and it builds an object for namespaces with namespace numbers equals text. I know a lot of this means nothing to most people watching, but bear with me. I'm going to go through it as quickly as I can. Then it creates a counter and goes through each namespace, and it creates a namespace index for the ID. If the index is greater than -1, then it goes in and it checks if the index is greater than 0, not equal to 4 or 5 or 111. So 0, greater than 0, so not -1, -2, or 0, not 4 or 5, which are already defined, and not 111, which is an erroneous duplicate of 201, I think. So if it's none of those broken ones or ones that are already defined, then define it. Create an index. Create namespace index. As whatever the iteration is. So basically it says index 0 is namespace 0. Index 1 is namespace 1. And that goes right through to 15. And then it gets namespace 200 is index 16. And namespace 201 is index 17. And namespace 274 is 18, and 275 is 19, and 500, which is the item namespace, is 21, and 501, which is item talk, is number 22. So it just builds an index for the namespace numbers and an object with the number of namespaces. And then we do get contributions, which it's just a function that I do call, but it doesn't do anything. It's actually that should be console.warn. I'm not going to use the not going to use that for this. And I can actually do percent string comma this user there, because I'm actually going to skip that for now because it's not functioning yet. I need to figure out, for like 3 years now, I've been trying to learn how to do promises, deferred, and callbacks, and it's just one of those things that I just haven't been able to pick up on. I haven't found the right tutorial on it yet that it just clicks in my head and goes, oh, that's how it works, so I understand how to use it. I've had people tell me how to use it, but I don't understand how it works, so telling me how to use it for one situation doesn't apply to the next situation very well. So yeah, if you know somebody that wants to suggest teaching me how those things work and why they work the way that they do, that would be awesome. It would be it would greatly increase my ability to do JavaScript and jQuery and all that good stuff. And then I do a function, which the comment's a little bit outdated, and I need to add more commenting to this. But basically, the acceptable log types according to the API are block, delete, import, merge, move, new user patrol, protect, stable, writes, and upload. You can only do one of those at a time. You can't batch them together, which is a real pain in the butt. So first thing I do is I say if the log type that they want when they call the function is in this array of acceptable log types, if it's not negative one, if it's not outside of the array, then log building an object to process, log users, log type. Great. And then we do a case where we switch on log type. If it's delete, then the log type name is contributions deleted, all logs is all deletions. Then we got move, we got import and protect, which use the same variables there. Patrol, merge, block, new user's rights, upload, stable, and that I'm not sure what stable is supposed to be logging. So I just put it down here with default and called it unknown. I should add an all logs for that. All logs. Unknown as well. Okay. These breaks are because when you're in a case switch, switch case, when it hits there, it won't stop unless it's got a break. It'll just keep going and look for another one. So once you find what you're looking for, you want to break out of the switch. Saves a little bit of time, a little bit of processing. All right, let's see here. Save. And then I define all users, all logs as 0. So whatever all users, log user, username, all logs, which is the type of log, define it as a number of 0. Otherwise, you're going to get a not a number error when you go to run it. Make sure that you define all users, username, log type name, which is writes changed or uploaded files or whatever. It's an array that's going to hold a list of edits per namespace by index. Then you're going to iterate through each namespace index 0 to 22, and it's actually 0 to 501. And because it goes namespace number index. So it says if numeric, if there's a value inside of the index, then create a number in all users, username, log type name, index number. So, and set it to 0. I know. I have a hard time following it, and I wrote it. So, and then we do a new API get, which goes through log events for the log type, for the log user. Don't need the format there either, but I'll clean that out later. And then log response for each response in log events, increment that namespace type, which is, so for the index of whatever's in log events index.namespace, increment it by 1. So it just counts through and adds them up. For each user log type name, function index, all users, username, all logs, add 1 to the log for that type. So as it counts through namespaces and makes, you know, separate counts for each namespace, it's also building a total count on the end. And then display the object. If it's not one of those log types up at the beginning, see how we had if in array, if it's not -1, then do this. If it is -1, if it's not in the array, then you're gonna do this. You're gonna log an error to the console that whatever type it is not a valid log type. This is our main function. Log events, obtaining a list of wiki users with edits. Do an API call. I got some temporary test stuff there. This is a temporary test thing, only do 10 at a time. I could actually trim that down to 3 even. Basically, it pulls from the API, and it does some number crunching, and then it goes through and it gets down to git contributions, which it's skipping for now. Once it's done with that, it does get the delete count. Once it's done with that, it gets the moves. Once it's done with that, it gets the patrol. Once it's done with that, it gets the protect. Once it's done with all of that, it will log the object. It will actually do a calculated edit count, which adds all of these pieces together. I'm using MW edit count for now because I have it set to skip the git contribution section. And then it will log what the results of all that is. And then this is just git namespaces, then git users, which does all the other stuff. When everything is all done, then it's supposed to say all process users and display an object for all users, which my synchronization is a little bit out. It's the whole promises and callbacks thing that I'm not getting. But we can shrink that down. We don't need it open right now, and we can take a look at what it looks like. Let me open it back up for a second. Copy. All right, so if I clear this out, this is testing in Chrome. I've also been testing in Firefox because they give different errors. We run this, and we watch it just go. We get some uncaught errors. We got skipping raw contributions. That's good. It's only doing 3 right now. That's awesome. So first thing it does is it obtains a list of namespaces, which is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are in order. And then it gets to 111, which is 16, 200 is 17, 201. I already talked about that. So we now have a namespace index, which is an array with 502 entries in it. Done building namespaces is an object, and it looks like this, which is the namespace number, and then the namespace name, which is awesome. Creating an object for technical 13, block log, all process user shows up here. It's not supposed to show up till at the end, but whatever. My completed object is here. It shows, oh, come on. It shows all blocks 460, all deletions 486, all moves 500. That's because I'm hitting a cap there. The API will only return 500 at a time. And because I'm not good at the callbacks, promises deferred thing, I can't make it loop through and continue to get more. Same thing with all patrols, all protects is 330. Block count is an object, and it should be a number. Blocked users is an array. It's absolutely useless because all blocked users are going to be in 460, are going to be in namespace 2, which is the user space. We have protected pages by namespace according to our index. So we have 1 and 19. So protected pages 19. We go back up here. 19 was 274, which is widget. So I protected a widget page there. I don't remember what the other ones are. And I know that there were some other protections, probably in, well, maybe not. But anyway, patrol pages, I've done a lot of patrolling in a lot of namespaces. Move pages is an array, shows all the moves. Contributions deleted, shows what namespaces I've deleted pages from. And it shows me a calculated edit count right now of 25909. Which still isn't quite right. There's some stuff missing, but I'll get to that. I'm not doing deleted contributions yet, so I know that'll show up when I do that. So anyway, that's what the script does. It doesn't work right because I don't have callbacks, promises, and deferred. I'll figure it out. Hopefully I can find somebody that can teach me those three things so that I can understand them and make use of them. I have a whole bunch of scripts that are waiting on me to figure out how that works. That would be greatly beneficial. So, now that we've done all of that, and I've talked my head off, and I don't know what I'm talking about, let's see here. Let's take a look and patrol this edit. Question icon. Ooh, good work, Amraf. You should be getting up there on contributions too, aren't you? Well, maybe not yet. You got what, 25, 30? We can take a look. Oh. Then there are uploads, so maybe. We'll see. Alright, so let's start opening some of these. That's SUSE. I don't want SUSE. I want Solar Power has 46 edits. There you go. Is there a prize for 100? No. Prizes are 500 plus. Although, you know, you might win most active in the last, you know, 60 days or something, 30 days, 90 days, when I actually get to that. I don't have data for that whatsoever. I can do 30 days. 30 days I can do. But I'm probably going to be that, so let's do That's not a problem, SUSE. I believe you got a prize, don't you? Yeah, you fall into the 2500 plus. You get 500 turbine points and your choice of a pet certificate. You've got 4,268 edits. You know, if you could get 732 more edits by the end of my stream in 45 minutes, yeah, probably not gonna happen. You'd be bumped up to the 5,000 tier though. Which is 1,000 turbine points. Titan, you'll probably... I've only seen a couple people so far enter the new editor award, so you might win one of those. Alright, so... what I'm gonna do here... recent changes. Upload log. You can see that it shows that I created an account because I created Albert Jr.'s account per request on DDO stream during the 10th anniversary show. Edward T underscore. Yeah, we just call him Eddie. Beholder. Getting some edits in there, good stuff. Mythic boost. Moves. Oh, that reminds me, I wanted to go through recent changes. Titan, you can't leave. Not unless you bring me back something. I love pastries. Donut. Muffin. Bear claw. Danish. Salivating. So, yesterday, while I was at work and I couldn't actually work on my JavaScript, I did quite a bit of page moving and... okay, don't worry about it, A. Horsley Jr. We will take care of it. I did a lot of ad pack icon moving and setting up. See, I did a lot of deletions there, a lot of page moving here, shuffling stuff around. A lot of cleaning up ad pack icons from pages. I even had to upload a bunch of ad pack icons. A bunch of them that I ended up having to delete. So I had to upload the icons. I had to move them. I had to delete the leftover redirects. So it was like 3-4 stage process for each one of these ad pack names, because the naming scheme changed. Yes, it is. It's on the wrong side of the country, Titan. Anyway. A lot of file work. Updated their categories and whatnot. There's a new discussion on the POI board. So basically, I did some work on Adventure Pack Icon Gallery. This is still a work in progress. Not completely done yet. I still need to sort by level and upload a couple missing icons, but they are now at exact name of pack, addpackicon.jpg. I had to move some of them from PNG as well, but we got some ad pack icons now. That project's been worked on. Missing a Druid Deep ad pack icon, and I'm not sure what to do with these just yet. Menace of the Underdark and Shadowfell, but I might have redirects for those. But anyway, it was a huge project I spent most of the day on. Well, relatively large. So, have Bruno added a new POI the other day, where he wants your feedback on changing the color scheme for the holidays on the top of the homepage. He likes New Year's as it is. He wanted to change Valentine's to this, which was horrible. I pointed that out. He revised some of these. And I, you know, let him know that the problem I had was the colors were not WCAG compliant for those holidays. He wasn't even aware of that. So we did a revised one based on this. We got links to the color contrast checker tool, so you can see what's compliant and what isn't. I basically left it as, I'm fine with your proposed replacements, not sure about Thanksgiving and Christmas. They seem plain and blurring to me. Leaving the discussion open for a couple minutes, or a couple weeks, so that you can comment. I'd like to get some more feedback from you on it. Now, back to the homepage. We can't edit the homepage on the stream. What was I thinking, right? But what we can do is, we can view the source, and that when we view the source, we'll see that a lot of stuff isn't directly on the homepage. There's quite a bit there, but a lot of it isn't there. A lot of it is actually in template, home, and then a subpage. So if we were to pick one of those pages, which is going to be protected as well as is Cascade protected from the homepage, but if we were to take one of those pages, for example, and we view source, because we can't edit it because it's Cascade protected. This page has been protected from editing because it is included on the following page, which is protected with cascading. So it's just a little bit of text. Excellent. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new page called 10th Anniversary. We can edit this page. It does not yet exist. So we're going to create a paragraph tag, which isn't really needed on the wiki, but for the purpose of this template, it's a good idea to have. I vote for ShoeMaker. All right, let's see here. This thread's wrapped up. Yeah, a lot of mine are too, Agu. All right, let's see here. Let's go back to page 2. We're not logged in. Logged in now. I vote for Shu. He's been helping me since 2011. Inspired him to become an admin. That was one for Nib. Thumbs up for Zhu, all editors. Okay, so we got Agenshar here. I like that. So we got user forums. All right, solar power. If you win one of the 5 starter packs or 500 turbine points, I will get in touch with you either on IRC or via PM or some way. Maybe email. I know how to get a hold of you anyways. All right, so forum user. I don't want to use a quote template, or do I? Maybe I do. Quote. Author. Quote equals. Source equals forums P equals display equals 0. I don't remember. Hey, Mandrel. Not forum user. Not gonna let me resize that any smaller. Is it forum user? Only 30 minutes left to work on this. I think we'll get it done. Other one's gonna be Tori. User forums. I don't know, I might have to look it up. There we go, there's Agonchar. To use their forums to something. So, there we go. Login, ID, login in the wiki. So that's wiki, forum user ID, forum name, Sig. Okay, so that's the one that I want right there. So, Agonchar, Agonchar, Torlon, Torlon, Torlon's ID is. Char's ID. Okay, we'll have that in a second. This is Torlon's ID. I can delete this all except for the number. Delete that. Actually, delete that. So if I go to Agonchar and I copy his link address and I paste it, I can delete this and then I can change that to a pipe, show preview. There we go. And that wasn't his comment. His comment was this. If you have something that you would like to be quoted on this page on the stream here, go to that thread. DDOwiki poll, who do you think has been the most influential wiki contributor? Thread number 468117. So if you just put in, yeah, I'll give you a link. You can still add your stories by visiting that URL, which it looks like has been broken by the exclamation point. So that link will work. You don't need the title, just need the number. All right, so we go up, go up here. Agenshar Shoemaker. We got GM Trojan. I don't think I should do a C also for this. Because I really don't like. Oh, right. I need to fix the link to Tori's post. That's not the right number. It's a minor edit. Alright, so let's see here. It's GM Trojan. Forum user is the other one. See, we get two of them, and I get confused of which one's which. So it's just going to be forum user for that one. And that's not that, but I can get that right now. Paste that in there, delete everything up to the number. This is going to be a user's forum. And he is... Nibbling, I believe. Oh, goody, my mouse batteries just died on me. Perfect timing. Gotta love wireless devices, right? Good Wiz Rogue War combo. Now, when you do this, line breaks don't show up properly. So you've got to force them. That. Hopefully I got Nibblung right. I did. Good. Should be a capital N though. We always do caps. Alright, let's go through here some more. 20 minutes. Some discussion. Don't know that Barter has an account, but doesn't exclude him from being quoted. Author equals forum user. Source equals forums P equals display equals 0 quote equals gonna be time shortly to pick our 5 winners for a starter pack or 500 turbine points. Edward, are you Edward T or Edward T underscore on Wiki? Edit away, Titan, edit away. Alright, so maybe this blurb isn't that short. I might trim it later. I just wanted to get all the information in here for now, to start with. And I probably spent way too much time... No underscore. Good. Okay. So your underscore is only on Twitch. Got it. Alright, so this isn't a very short blurb, is it? Comment all that out. Alright, so. Let's see if there's any more stories about it. It has indeed. And that's that. Alright, so that's all of our stories that we got from the forums there. Do you know what they want? So I'm in the kitchen looking for food and my cats come in giving me the eyes. Do you know what they want, Shoe? Yeah, they want you to pick them up, put them on your lap while you're watching the stream and pet them. Give them love. All cats want love. Probably gonna run a little bit over on the stream today. Have I been to Washington? I've landed there when I was heading out to Oregon.
Hmm.
Merciless Onslaught, that's a Kenneth guild. I believe. I'm certainly gonna run a little bit over today. I actually think I discussed it a month back on our Slack channel for DDO stream, and Cordovan said not to worry about it. I believe it's gonna be an extended show for probably another hour, just to make sure everything is set the way it should be. So, I've got a start of a short blurb. Let's take a look at what that looks like. The community has chosen a most influential DDOwiki contributor for the last decade, and their choice was Technical 13, contributes message email ShoeMaker. So, per the event description, here's a short blurb about why people pick Technical 13. And need to put a line break in there. ShoeMaker is a bottomless resource of knowledge, help and guidance in wiki etiquette, encouraging attitude with an obvious goal of always looking to enhance others' knowledge. I shouldn't say DDO forums, it should say who commented that. So we're gonna fix that. Forums. Label equals. Because it's a link, I can't do that, but I can go down here and grab Hagenshar on the DDO forums. Has brought a few contributors. Was Edward? No. Who was that? Who said that? Makes the newcomer feel welcome was Edward. A great one. All right, so let's take a look here. There we go. What else can we do? Let's break these quotes up a little bit so they're easier to find. Separate. Yep, so you'll be quoted. I think that's just about everything summed up, except for one last one. T-Dog. I'm gonna twist your words around. So let's do a show preview. In a moment. I'm actually gonna do a double line break there. Say page. So there is our short blurb created on the stream based on your comments. All of the actual quotes are still going to be on the page. Gosh, I'm hungry. And I need more coffee. So, now what we need to do is go here. Nope, wrong page. Go to the talk page. Add topic. I love that music. Request for edit. Can an administrator please add in an appropriate box on the home page for, I love spell check. And always sign your posts. And yes, I'm just gonna switch over to Firefox and put it up there. Where should it go? That's the next question. I'm thinking between what's new and sitemap. Or I really don't want to put it at the bottom. I want it to be near the top. Should it be a... Maybe it should be right above what's new. Sounds like a good plan. Yeah, it doesn't work on mine either. Minion Mania is back at Redbox. Interesting. So let's open up this. Albert, it's still not showing you as a user. Let's see if I can do something here. What does DDOwiki VIP give you? Looking something up real quick. As a part of all, implicitly. Look at that. So it's implied. It's not explicit, it's implied. Hey Albert, why don't you see if you can log in now? I just gave you DDOwiki VIP, which I'm hoping will override the fact that you're not in users and allow you to do something. Alright, so homepage. Alrighty, here's our homepage. This is all bug-eyed over here because I went from a short screen to a long screen. Just refreshing it will fix it. It's actually interactive JS, so we're going to put it above what's new for now. Let's add this to our homepage. Welcome header, body section, players council. What's new? Home, and what was the name of our thing? 10th anniversary? Show preview. I need to set up a script that makes it impossible to, I don't like the way that interacts with that. Stick it there. Alright, not bad, but I need to put in a box. Let me grab one of these boxes here. One of the cool things I have on my computer is this little color picker. Grab that. And where's my color here? Oh. Grab the. Let me look at update 26. It's going to be using the news template. Thank you. Not sure where that pipe comes from. Yes, I know that that box looks weird, but once I save it, it'll run the JavaScript, it'll be fine. Why isn't it changing the color of that, though? Oh, it did. It dumped it. Except that does that to it. I don't like that. So div ID, PCs, that's not right. So it's gonna be, div ID is gonna be just anniversary. There we go, that's better. Pick an icon too. Which icon should I use for 10th anniversary? Page C icons. Images. Icons by size. Should we use a DDO logo? Let's see what we got there. We could do the old DDO.gif. Kind of like the long ones. Maybe the DDOwiki logo version 3? Version 2? Kind of like having Vela in the background. Kind of like the Cinder spawn in the background too. Let's go with version 2. I like that. I like that logo. Shows some history. What's 120 look like? Not big enough. What if I do, instead of doing that, let's do, what if I do X60? X60px should force a height of 60 to match the other ones. Image info 160 by 60. So I can force it to 160 by 60. X60 is fine. Alright, so that does that. Let's see if I can figure out that pipe. No, they're not taking applications yet. But I do want to make that consistent. Not magic words, I want parser functions. What do you mean? I want day, so I want L. Comma. F. FJ. Capital Y. I'm just gonna throw in February 1st for now, even though they're not taking them yet. That section's commented out. Okay, so 10th anniversary. Style equals background color. I'll force my background color by picking it. Pasting it. And that's the edit link. Got a pipe here to get rid of. Show preview. There it is. Except we're not getting the color yet. Why aren't I getting my color? Oh, okay, because that's in the wrong section. This goes ID. It goes there. Show preview. Should be the same reddish color. But do we want red or do we want green? I kind of want green. Shoe, make up your mind. I kind of like this green right here. Yep, you'll have to get in touch with Cordovan. There we go, I like that. Looks good. Let's publish it. Let's move it down under what's new, though. There we go. Alrighty, let's see what it looks like. This may take a while to cache through and purge for it before everybody can see it. Oh, yeah. Alright, so there it is. 10th anniversary grand prize blurb. The DDOwiki community has chosen a most influential DDOwiki contributor for the last decade, and their choice was ShoeMaker. So per the event description, here is a short blurb about why people picked Technical 13. ShoeMaker. It'll say Technical 13 for most people there. Or it should. Let's see what it looks like. There it is. The Technical 13. Why people pick Technical 13. ShoeMaker is a bottomless resource of knowledge, help and guidance in wiki etiquette, encouraging attitude with an obvious goal of always looking to enhance others' knowledge. From Eginshar, his weekly DDO stream show on Twitch TV has brought few contributors to the wiki. A great one. As he makes the newcomer feel comfortable and supportive to all contributors. Now that it's included on the homepage, I can't go back and edit this as DDO stream, but I can as Technical 13. I should expand this one right here to include the other people that mentioned the stream. So let's do that. But first, let's add this image to the other side as well, because I like the idea of having two images up top. Except that's not gonna work because it's a box cell icon. Evans, if I delete that. Delete that. Right, left. That'll do it. Except I don't like the way that it bumps that text in. So let's not do that. Let's just go down and pick on 10th anniversary. Alrighty. You'll see that it's got a warning. This page has been protected, so only users with system operator privileges can edit it because it's included in the following Cascade Protected Pages home. So only administrators can edit this now because it's used on the homepage. can't see the text very well here. What was I gonna change? Oh yeah, I was gonna add some more sources. Great one, Edward's stream comment. Niblung. And Nibble was this post. I don't want to do more than three, but so there's Nibble, GM Trojan. I believe I've commented everybody except Bardar here. I think I get everybody. Alrighty. So it's time to pick our winners for new editors from the wiki. So if I go to special active users, boy, that's a mess. Let's open up the console here. MW API is not a function, huh? Interesting. Clear that out. Alright, so if I go import script MediaWiki gadget special pages active users.js, it's not gonna run. Alright. Oh, I know why. So if I grab the guts of that script instead of importing it and run that, we can get a list of most active contributors. Thank you. So, that's just collecting data. Go down here, we see that our most active editor in the last 30 days has been JJ. So, we can actually put that one in there for the last 30 days. Most active in the last 30 days. And I don't have a prize yet, but it's going to be user JJMC89 with 625 edits. Time L FJY minus 30 days. Still don't have a prize pick for that. What should we give for a prize? Since December 6, 2015. Community list item. Let's do any community list item. It can be a pet certificate if they want. The second prize should be any two. Section 4. Or 500 turbine point code. Yep, that's what I want right there. Two items or 500 turbine points. And 500 turbine points. And then in the last year, 3 and 2 500 turbine point codes. There we go. So we got some prizes there now. filling it in here. All right, so 15 minutes. Let's do our starter packs, which is what we were gonna do in the first place. All right, active user lists. I know that new editors from the stream. We've got Titan. We've got Seljuk and Edward. We've got Solar Power, who's Amref. We've got who else is new here from the stream? We've got Gary, but he doesn't want to be entered. I've already talked to him. Ooh, enemy food. With two edits. If I'm skipping you in this list, and you are a new editor to the wiki from... Some call me Tim. If you're a new editor to the stream, to the wiki from the stream, let me know. I'm only going by the last 30 days right here. What was the other one? Oh, we got Laurel too, don't we? We have our Esking that I gotta look up, make sure they have an edit to be eligible. My contributions, and I put in R Esking. They have 7 edits, so they are editable. They are eligible. Although they've had an account since January 2013, so they're not new from the stream. I'm looking for new editors from the stream. Laurel, we had Laurel in there, I saw. Laurel's Way, number 57. Was Danny. Oh, you're getting entered. Let's see here. Who else do we have? That's all that I recognize. So if I missed you and you're a new editor, so that's what we got there. New editors from the stream. User 9 with 174 Titan. User 11 with 154 Seljuk. User 12 with 146 edits in the last 30 days, Edward. User 15 with 50 edits in the last 30 days, Solar Power, Amref. 2 edits, Laurel, Daniela. And with 2 edits, Enemy Food. So I've got to pick five of you. So, what I'm going to do to make this easy, so I'm going to load up Turbine TP code giveaway thingy-majiggy, and I'm going to put in anniversary prize. Don't need any. We're going to have Titan. We're going to have Seljuk. Edward. Solar Power. Amref. Lurl's Way. And enemy food. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we've got 6 people here. So we've got to roll for 5 of those. Well, actually, Laurel said they didn't want to be entered, so it's going to be everybody except Laurel that gets one. So we're just going to copy the list here. I don't even need that, because Laurel said they didn't want to be entered. So we go so, we're going to have hey, Titan, you won one. Titan. Pull up your contributions and your join dates. Titan has 178 edits. Since October 6, 2015, December 23rd. You guys all have over 100 edits so far as well. That's awesome. Well, except for solo power. Get editing, Amref. Enemy only has one edit. You too, enemy food. Get editing. I should actually pull those two back open. Check their logs. He created his account on January 2nd. So he hasn't had it very long yet. Logs. 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 Titan created on October 6th. That one's right. Selge created on December 22nd. So they actually made their account the day before they started editing. Solar Power was October 13th. And Edward was October 7th. All right, let's take a look. There we go. I will send you an email through the DDOwiki system. You will need to reply to me directly. I don't believe you can actually reply to the email. I believe you actually have to send me a direct reply. I will include an email link in there. So, there's that. And that wraps up our stream for today. So, we figured out who the grand prize was.
Yeah, whoa, whoa, yeah.
Alright, I'm done. I don't want to be, over-celebratory. Grand prize winner was me. I put up the blurb on the homepage. I'll get in touch with Quarter Vanable Prizes, Edit Count Prizes. I've filled in that chart based on what data I have currently available. There may be a few more additions at a later time. The cutoff date is today at 11 a.m. Eastern Time. So any data that I gather from here will have a cutoff time of right now. So you don't have to worry about that. There'll be nobody scraping in 1,000 edits today and tomorrow to, in the next week while I work on the script to finish getting the information to win a prize. Not happening. But I still encourage you to try to get 1,000 edits in a week. If you can get 1,000 non-bot, non-miner edits in a week, you get in touch with me. I will hook you up with some kind of prize. We figured out our most active in the last 30 days. So JJ is going to get a couple prizes. He's going to get 1,000 turbine points, a pet certificate, and any other community loot list item that he wants. I don't know about those ones yet, but those people will get an email from me about a starter pack or a 500 turbine point code. So, be sure to tune in on Sunday where we go back to Orion and run on our Dwarven Barbarian for levels 4, 5, 6, and maybe 7. Don't forget to tune in next week for DDOwiki Talk, where I will go back to my weekly prize giveaway. It'll either be a 500 point turbine code or something else. Other than that, have a great week, everybody. See you on Sunday.